Professor Suranarayan. Our distinguished guest from Sri Lanka, Member of Parliament, Sumantharam. Respected Satchidanandan. And dear friend Dr. Ashik. Persons eminent who have participated in the earlier sessions. Respected Rajan. And person who has chaired from BJP, State Vice President Chakravarti. And BJP State President Dr. Tamilisai, and very senior leader and elder politician from our party, Sri Laganesham. And many eminent persons and who have been taking keen interest in this subject and who have participated in this seminar. I could not listen to the speakers in the first session. I came a little late. This is a very important and serious subject for the country. After 10 years of UPA rule, people are looking to this government with lot of hope. Few days back when I had an opportunity to visit Sri Lanka to participate in an international conference of political parties and its leaders, before getting into the subject, I am just presenting the contextual background. Leaders from all political parties, including leaders from Chinese Communist Party to Japan and Russia, everybody had come to participate in that conference. In the conference, I attended this kind of conference even 4 years back, 5 years back in China and some other places. So this time the experience for me was different. When I attended similar kind of conference 4 years back, of course at that time the ruling party was Congress and the leader who was representing Congress was Manish Tiwari. So I had an opportunity to see, and that experience is with me. And this time I was representing the ruling party there in Colombo. So the experience, when I am saying that it is not only my experience in the 4 years back conference and now, it is not that, even the experience of the ruling party's leader. In this time, I could see the difference. Politicians from Pakistan, politicians from China, politicians from all countries, they were very eager, they were very attentive to what we are going to say, what we want to say. So everybody was interested in hearing from BJP. Why the difference? Just I asked different leaders, why this kind of difference is there? The difference is BJP. The difference is Narendra Modi. Both. The difference is because of Narendra Modi is more pronounced. But The difference is also because of BJP, it may be less pronounced thing, but BJP is seen as a party with a strong nationalistic credentials. And the attention is there, more attention is there because of the decisive character of Narendra Modi. Narendra Modi being the Prime Minister there. So this is, now everybody all over the world is watching what India has to say. This is an opportunity for the country. And irrespective of parties and leaders and ideologies, I see this is an opportunity for the country, and it has got some kind of added advantage. This time, now the country's population is also big. A democratic country with 125 crore population, you won't have any other country. This is not a small thing. Now a successful democracy, functioning democracy, vibrant democracy, and where the change of government takes place without any problem, and the people debate and people participate in discussions, and they participate in campaigns, and they participate in voting in a very free way, where election commission is very independent and election commission is very active, and it comes out with lot of reforms, election to election reforms. Even now we have number of things we want election commission to do and change. But at present also the contribution of election commission is very significant. This kind of framework, this kind of political praxis we have with this huge population backing. And this election is an election with very high turnout. It is not a small population. 120 crore population. And this leader from BJP who has got elected now as the Prime Minister of the country has got 17 crore votes. It is this number is more than the population of many countries. So you have to understand why this leader is getting so much attention. Why this government is getting so much attention? It is none what one angle, it has got multi dimensions. So we have to see this as an advantage for the country, in my view. Because people are seeing this as a factor. So a country with the decisive leadership and with the decisive backing of the people, very popular government we have, and where even press people cannot dare to ask me that who is running this government, whether this power or that power, whether remote control or front driving or rear driving, you cannot. Even for the provoking sake, now media people can ask me. Everybody knows all over the world it is now very clear that who runs the government. That is the situation. So who runs the government means I am ready to accept my accountability. When somebody is running the government, it is known, it means he is accepting the accountability. So this situation is for the first time after 10 years it has come to this country. So the real potential of the country can get manifested at the global level. This is the first important thing which we have to keep in our mind. It's the transcending the partisan. This is a very important thing. And second important thing what we have to see is this country, after so many years, has come to a stage where a leader can be independent of the compulsions of the coalitions. This is also a very important development you have to understand, which has a bearing in our problem. There is no compulsion now. Now there is no compulsion means there is no excuse for the leadership. Both. You can't ask for the excuse from the people that, well, we are dependent on this, we are dependent on that, what to do, what not to do. And it gels with the leader. This leader cannot go and tell that I have a problem. Our prime minister, he is such a personality, he cannot go to and tell the people that I have a problem, compulsion is there. Compulsion and Narendra Modi cannot coexist. So this is another important thing which has come to our advantage. So these are the two things in my view, in the present context, which has got a bearing. I want to, at the very outset, I want to elaborate. Now, there is an open session, and I am a politician now, and this is a seminar. The seminar has got academic character, but politician can never become an academician. So, what I am going to say here is, Sri Lanka and India, there is a natural marriage. Nature has created. It is not that we have decided. The present generation and the past generation has not decided to create Sri Lanka and India like this. It is there. Natural marriage. So in the natural marriage, one is committed to other. A fidelity is an essential principle. Dating with other is unacceptable. Dating with other is another is unacceptable. It is not that if it applies to only one partner, it's not the thing, even it applies to us. We cannot excuse ourselves when the other party is in a problem. So in the same way, they are also in the same position. So the commitments are same. Loyalty is one. So when I say security of India, people tend to get a feeling that it is a security of India. Security of India cannot never be a separate thing from security of Sri Lanka. India freedom is endangered. India civilization is endangered. India physical security is endangered. India sovereignty is endangered. And Sri Lanka is flourishing. Sri Lanka's culture, civilization, identity is flourishing. Can you see any day of that kind? It is impossible. We have to swim and sink together. So dating with another is impossible, one has to understand. Flirtation is unacceptable. One has to realize. If you do not realize this, then you will be in the soup. So this has to be, distant friends are always only distant friends. Indian security is inalienably linked to the security of Sri Lanka. And Sri Lanka's existence is inalienably linked to the India's glory. This is a very important thing. And this
It is not a private thing which I am telling in the seminar. I can speak in the same way in the United Nations Security Council. No power in the world can challenge India's position in the Indian Ocean and create a viable alternative in the Indian Ocean. It is not an illegitimate thing, it is a legitimate thing. If a government in Delhi is not able to understand its duty and its potential, it is the weakness of that government, it is unmanliness of that government and its leadership, it is not otherwise. And BJP as a leadership, as a party, understands all these things. And the leadership which thinks that it should get a seat in Security Council and it deals with this population, with this economy, with this technology, with this youth and with this scientific infrastructure. We are deprived and 1947's architecture has got inherent imbalance at the global level and it cannot administer the global governance without adequate representation from India. And you are not ready to take the responsibility in Sri Lanka, then you are not there to have a position. A position in Security Council is not a luxury. It has not a responsibility. So the South Asia will in coming days, whenever the power in Delhi has got a decisive leader with the nationalist credentials, will go for more and more integrated development. Whenever a power or person in Delhi is weak, then the